Hi guys, how you doing? My name is Baruch Kogan. I'm a programmer living and working in Israel. I built this project called CrowsNest for the Redis hackathon. And basically what the project does is it uses various Redis capabilities, Redis AI, Redis streams, and so on, to ingest video, identify people that are in the video, or identify that there are people in the video, and let the user know, and let the user change the video feed and the model, the TensorFlow model that it uses to identify these people on the fly. The reason I built this project is I have the Israel dog unit next door, and these guys are out there every week rescuing people that are lost, people that whatever's happened to them, they're combing through the various areas that they might be in using dogs and drones. And so this would be a useful tool for them to be able to detect that there's a person in the image with drones. Okay, so let me show you how it works. So here's what this looks like in practice. Here's our little control console. This is just a placeholder image that my stack is producing. Let's see what files are actually on the server, okay, and the models that we have available. So we have an actual search and rescue sample file. Let's give it a second. While it loads. Here we go. So you can see here's a little spark line, lets me know there's people in the image. You can see that this model is not great at identifying people from like an overhead angle, from a high angle. Here, part of the game just cut off. There we go. A second. So for this goes to show that we need to train up new models that will be able to identify humans from a high angle of attack, and also in thermal footage, because a lot of the searches involve people that are laying down on the ground at night, in the field at weird angles, and in limited visibility conditions, a lot of times through thermal footage. And so this project should really give the operator the flexibility to adjust the model, a specifically trained up model for whatever visibility conditions and whatever spectrum that the camera's in. That's kind of the whole point of this project. So hopefully, as we continue to build this thing, as I continue to build this thing, it'll become useful to the point where it'll take the load off the operator and actually help them save lives. Improvements in the near future include live feed URLs that you'll be able to submit on the fly. So from an RTMP server that we set up for the drone, to rebroadcast the incoming footage, building and testing custom TensorFlow models, as I mentioned, a simultaneous processing of multiple video feeds so that we can set up multiple drones and they can sweep out automatically patterns, and one guy can monitor this app and see if the drones have spotted people. Audio alerts, so that you don't necessarily have to be staring at the screen every second, and they deploy them to the cloud. Parenthetically, I really enjoyed building this project. I'm not a Python or Docker or computer vision or AI guy by background. I'm just a full stack web developer. So this let me really get my feet wet and all that stuff, and access Redis's more advanced features, which I think are great, and I plan to be using a lot more of in future projects. So thank you guys for this opportunity, and have a good one.